Since we last talked, SMU did pick up a transfer commitment, and that is Matthew Hibner from Michigan, a national champion with the Wolverines and a guy who has 2 years of eligibility remaining. Matthew Hibner will join the program as that really that blocking tight end that Casey Woods has been looking for in that room. And with Matthew Hibner, he's somebody that won a national championship, kind of similar to Owen Condon back when SMU brought him in that sense, because they were able to bring him in. And, you know, he had that national championship experience for Georgia. Hibner never started on offense for the Wolverines, but he did win 3 Big Ten titles as well as that national championship this past year. He didn't play as a true freshman in 2020. He's got 2 career receptions for 15 yards, but he's also been a key special teamer. And let me tell you, I've talked about him in the past on this podcast, but I thought he was an offensive tackle when I saw him out at practice for SMU when he was taking his visit, and he will have 2 years of eligibility. He was able to redshirt this season as the Wolverines went on their run to the national championship and winning it, and still played in 7 games. But what happened was, and I talked with Matthew, the full story is going to be dropped at On the Pony Express this week. He hurt his hamstring in fall camp, and he missed the first game of the season and then got back, and he was playing through it, and it just wasn't getting better. And so he went into compliance and said, hey, do I have a redshirt opportunity? Because I'd like to keep playing college football, but can I redshirt and can we let this heal? And then I can help the team in the postseason. And he went to the coaching staff and they said, absolutely. Sounds great. And if you watch the Alabama game, he made a big tackle down on special teams, and his teammates were pumped for him. And I got the sense of talking with him, very mature young man, wants to come in and do 2 years at SMU, be in that blocking tight end role, maybe get some opportunities to catch the ball, working behind RJ Maryland and probably Adam Moore in terms of pass catching options for SMU. But he adds size, and he is – not somebody that I feel like is a projection at this standpoint. Like when SMU ultimately brought in Micah Hiltz, it was, okay, wow, this guy is supposed to be, you know, depth. I personally thought he was going to be bigger than he was, but he was really kind of lanky. Matthew Hibner is really what Casey Woods has been looking for at the tight end room. Maryland, Kentucky, NC State, and others offered him as well. And so you bring him in, he's going to help you on special teams. He's going to be a veteran about just about every way he works. And I think that's important, is you don't want to bring in somebody who's going to rock the boat or be an issue. And I think he fits exactly what Casey Woods wanted, which is a blocking tight end. If they can get some receptions out of him, great. You know he knows how to play all over the field as a tight end, because that's what Michigan does. They play in 12 personnel. They play in 13 personnel. They move their tight ends all over the field. That's what SMU has been able to do at times with their tight ends as well. And if they can get someone who's not a full-blown H-back, like when they have Stone Eby or Elijah Chapman out there at times in the past, which is declaring, hey, we're probably going to run the football, this helps your offense just a teeny bit. I'm not sitting here saying he's going to be an all-conference. Not sitting here saying he's going to even catch a pass this year. But if he can come in and be a solid blocker and he can be physical at the point of attack, remember, leaving Michigan, won a national championship there in a loaded tight end room, he's going to have a chance to make a positive impact on this team, and he'll have 2 years to do it as well. So Matthew Hibner did commit to the Mustangs while we were on that little bit of a break too. So when it comes to the transfer portal, again, I have SMU, and actually I might be at 80 now that I think about that. Yep, I have not added Matthew Hibner. So Matthew is now on the roster on my scholarship board. So SMU is at 80 now, and they'll have 5 spots to play with by my count, and that's before we've seen anyone enter the portal or anyone else enter the portal from SMU. Now, some people will say, all right, what are we going to expect here from SMU? And I think what Rhett Lashley and his staff have built is a roster that they want to be very careful with. And they have to be very careful because they've position this culture to be a very strong one. And I think we've seen that even as they've, you know, lost some key guys. They lose Elijah Chapman on defense. They lose some of those offensive linemen. They're going to be a different team than they were in 2023. Obviously, they're taking a huge step up as well. But what this team goes about well is work. And they have an ability to focus on what they need to do day in, day out. And that's because if you look at this roster, 22 guys going into their final year of eligibility by my count. That's a lot. And how do they welcome in players this summer that haven't been around the culture? And maybe if they're brought in to be a very competitive offensive tackle battle or a very competitive cornerback room battle, how do they mesh with their teammates? And that's something that's very important with Rhett Lashley and his staff. If you look up and down this roster, and this isn't to disparage others, but it's just a reality now, there really haven't been as many guys that you look at and you say, oh, that's a bad egg, that's a bad egg, that's a bad egg. I think they've gotten away from some of those guys that when you went out to practice, you knew that guy's just not doing anything. He's hurt, he's, you know, hurt in quotations or whatever. They've done a nice job of fixing this roster to make it competitive top to bottom. I really believe that. And, you know, there are guys that aren't going to play and there are guys that are ultimately going to transfer and there are guys that have really earned the opportunity to play a lot and be the starters and all those things. It's any football team. But you look at this roster now and there are very few guys that you sit there and look at and you say, wow, that guy is really a true dead weight, not giving it this and that on this roster. And so the important thing is to make sure you don't bring in somebody who's really going to muddy the waters in certain position rooms, or really, quite honestly, all the position rooms. So that's going to be important as they go through this. What will happen is the transfer portal window will open. I think we'll start to see some guys maybe start taking visits later this month. SMU is done with spring ball, so they can do all this. They can go out and recruit them if they want to. In terms of the coaches getting out on the road, they can do all these things. But this is something that probably over the next couple weeks to a month, that's where we'll start to see commitments. That's when we'll start to see decisions being made and things like that. And the board emerge, you know. Andrew Chambly is an Arkansas transfer who's an SEC all-freshman selection a couple years ago and is getting a lot of buzz in the transfer portal. Well, SMU is one of the teams that, of course, is going to be linked to him because he's an offensive tackle and he's young and he's got opportunities to be a really good one long term. He's expected to visit Colorado, Kansas State, UCLA, Virginia Tech. SMU is interested in him. He started 8 games in 2023. And at the end of the day, he moved on and was going to just turn to life away from football, but decided to re-engage with football here over the course of the spring. And so now he's in the portal and he's one of the top available offensive linemen. Doesn't necessarily mean SMU is going to bring him in for a visit. Again, they have to really evaluate the fit and make sure things will play out well.